Thank you for joining us and welcome to this virtual kickoff to the admission season. Our purpose today is to help guide you through the admissions process, since we know it will be a very different process for you during this time than it has been for families in the past. We've been planning and planning for you and are excited to get started. Whether you're very familiar with Country Day or this is your first time considering an independent school for your family, we want you to have all the information you need to make the right decision for your family. Choosing a school is about finding the right learning environment for your child, but also finding a community for your entire family, a place to learn, grow, and develop lifelong friendships. Our academic community has made significant adjustments this school year to continue to deliver an excellent program for our students while keeping them as safe and healthy as possible. And that is the goal for our admissions season. We want to give you a tangible process, as tangible a process as possible, for the kind of experience your child will have at Country Day. We want to share with you how we have pivoted to meet the challenges during this exceptional time, but also want to share what Country Day life was like for our students, teachers, and families before March, and what it will certainly be like again in the future. Before we get to some of the nuts and bolts of the admissions process, we're going to hear from a few others on what makes Country Day such a special, joyful place. You'll see images of school life from our current school year, along with scenes from past years. First, please welcome our head of school, Mark Reed. Mark is in his 12th year as head, and in that time, he has led Country Day through a period of exceptional growth, both in physical space and in programming that supports our ability to make every child Country Day ready to thrive, to be a leader, to be a thinker, to be a doer, and to make a difference in a fast-changing global society. Mark.
Welcome, everyone, and thank you for joining us. As Nancy said, this is a very unusual year, but the way we've responded is not. Last year, at their virtual graduation ceremony, I told our seniors that we all have the opportunity to define this time that we're living in, rather than have it define us. I can't tell you how proud I am of the abundant spirit of community that I see every day. From students and teachers who are adapting and working hard, to phone calls and emails from parents who've shown tremendous flexibility and trust. This spirit stems from who we are as a school community. We're intentional about providing the very best for your children in academics, arts, athletics, and service to others in a wonderful and welcoming community. We constantly strive for academic excellence while also knowing the importance of teaching moral courage and kindness. We're a school that leans toward the future and remains strong. Over the past 5 years, we've built new learning spaces that give our students an even more innovative learning experience, one that will make them ready for the future. As I've said many times before, this is a school where a child will be known, where they'll be loved, where they'll be challenged, and where they'll be inspired. Yes, we're keenly aware and focused on academics, but we're also focused on global awareness, cultural fluency, and ultimately raising well-rounded leaders for tomorrow. In the weeks and months ahead, I welcome you to get to know more about Charlotte Country Day School and experience the vitality of our entire community. Next up, please listen to some of our students, faculty, and parents as they share more about their experience at Charlotte Country Day. Our children leave here absolutely prepared for their next academic step. When 100% of your students go off to college and to, quite frankly, some of the best colleges in the country and in the world, and they are successful because they know how to study, they're confident in their academic abilities and thrive.
The first thing you're going to notice when you visit Country Day is the balance of the program. So you're going to experience a curriculum that places equal emphasis on moral development, on character development, and also academic development. And we understand as a school that all three go hand in hand.
Technology I think it fits perfectly with where we are in society right now, because it's always changing. That we're using Apple Classroom, Google Classroom, there are all types of platforms they were already using before we were dismissed for the pandemic. The kids are working on their iPads daily because of that one-to-one technology piece. They're already used to daily working on their iPads to submit assignments.
When I first came, I was super nervous for like middle school, and I was like, wow, it's gonna be even harder online. But the teachers, they just made it so easy. Like, I just like list the stuff on Google Classroom, and then we just do it. It's super fun.
The science programming that we have at Country Day begins in the lower school, and it's integrated, particularly in terms of the skills that we teach the students. Lower school prepares them, gets them thinking about the scientific method. In the upper school, we have experts in their field. We teach a huge variety of classes. Many of our courses actually are university level classes, and they get experiences which are, I think, unique to the area, particularly in terms of offerings such as organic chemistry and our research classes, which you won't find anywhere else.
Our objective is to prepare our students to be successful in an ever-changing world, and in order to do that, we need to help mold students to be creative, to be empathetic, to be resilient. So those skills that have always been important are especially important as we prepare our students to be successful in the 21st century.
They love to do this. They want to build and they want to design. By being open-ended and not telling children this is what we're going to make, or showing them a model, it enables that child to be able to have their imagination run wild.
These are the teachers that cultivate your mind, that honestly make you think about what is the art of thinking. And it's been a spark to my intellectual capabilities, and that's the coolest thing, I think.
When we were looking at different schools, I wanted to find the school that provided the tools that kids would need as they transition through different stages of the educational process, and had to really be a school that provided that academic rigor and demanded academic excellence. And Country Day fit that mold perfectly.
And we were really impressed by the investments that they were putting into the math and science and makerspace, and we felt like it was a great progression that our children would grow with the school into the 21st century.
The honor system, kind of that idea of doing your best even when no one's watching. You don't need that external validation, you don't need that applause to do the right thing, to live a whole life, to be good to others, to be true to yourself.
But you feel like that this is your home, almost a second home, that the teachers care about you, so I think that's really important.
Forward city street driving, what does that look like? We're extremely fortunate to have PE every day, junior kindergarten through fourth grade, to really build and establish the value of physical activity as just a part of their everyday life.
You know, whether it's Spanish instruction at the youngest grades, Spanish and French as they go on later into lower school, science class, art class, daily PE, social emotional support through our guidance program. You know, our youngest students are having these strong foundations built that are helping prepare them for what lies ahead.
I was my teacher that Century Day this month.
This is a school where a child will be known, where they'll be loved, where they'll be challenged, where they will be inspired.
Country Day.
Country Day ready.
Country Day ready.
Country Day ready. Now and always.
Now and always.
I hope you enjoyed hearing from members of our community. Luckily, this event is going to be on our website, so you can go back and look at the video again if you like. Whenever I look at one of our videos like this, it takes me back to when I was teaching in lower school before joining admissions. The joy of getting to know my students, the partnership with parents, and the support I had from the administration made teaching truly magical. Leaving the classroom to work in admissions was a hard decision for me, but being able to share the Country Day story with families like you has been rewarding in so many ways. One is helping prospective parents find a school that meshes with their values, hopes, and dreams for their children. And best of all is that I get to see children enter Country Day, whether at junior kindergarten or ninth grade, and watch them blossom into amazing young people. My husband and I are thankful for the education our daughters received as lifers at Country Day, but also for the relationships with teachers and other adults in our community who were instrumental in their development and happiness. I imagine you are looking for the same thing. Before we wrap up our Admissions 101 session, I want to remind you about a few up-and-coming events already scheduled. The first is October 22nd, we'll have our junior kindergarten to fourth grade virtual open house. We're offering it twice that day, once at 9:30 in the morning and once at 7 p.m., as we know schedules are not quite like they were before COVID. We'll also host an upper school open house on November 12th at 7 p.m., and then an Affirming Community Diversity, Equity, Inclusion evening on Thursday, November 17th at 7 p.m. to help you learn more about our affirmation of community, our mission, and who we are as a school. Please join us. Throughout the season, we'll have other small events targeting a variety of topics of interest, and you'll be hearing from us about when they will be. Now, before we end, I just want to remind you of a few steps that you'll be taking as you go through the next few months. Step one is to schedule a virtual talk and tour with someone in our office. Step two is to RSVP for one of our open houses. Step three, remember to submit your application because that really gets everything going, so don't forget to do that. Step four, schedule your child's testing. You'll see the details of that on our website. And step five, refer to our website often to learn more about a community. There's a lot of wonderful information there. Thank you for being with us today. We look forward to getting to know you and your children in the coming months.